here to discuss you the sewing tools and equipment, and we will focus on marking tools and drafting tools. First is dressmaker carbon paper. This is used with a tracing wheel to transfer construction marks from the pattern to the block. And if you don't have carbon paper, you can also use manila paper and cartolina. And it is available with white and other colors. It makes it more quick, easy, and accurate. It produces identical marks on both layers of the pattern. Next is tracing wheel. Tracing wheel is used with or without dressmaker carbon paper to transfer pattern markings to the block. The wheel may damage some materials like knits and other delicate fabrics. And I'll show you the tracing wheel. And this is the example of tracing wheel. Next is tailor's chalk. Tailor's chalk is used for marking directly on the fabric, sharpen the chalk edge, often to produce thin lines for better accuracy in marking. And this is the example of tailor's chalk. I also have here tailor's chalk, and it's so tiny. And this is the latest version of tailor's chalk. Next is French curve. This is used for shaping the neckline and arm moves. And it looks like this. This is the French curve. Next is hip curve. This is used for shaping the hip, skirt, hemline, and other long curve lines. This is the examples of hip curve. Something like this. Next is tailor square or L square. This is an example of L square. It is used for drawing perpendicular lines, obtaining square corners, and dividing measurements. Here, I'll show you again some marking tools and drafting tools. First is L square. And next is the hip curve. Next is the French curve. Next is tailor's chalk. Tailor's chalk. Next is tracing wheel. Something like this. Next is dressmaker carbon paper or manila paper. I hope you guys have an idea about sewing tools and equipment, and all the equipment I show you is the marking tools and